Hi, welcome to another Azure.NET Quick Start. My name is Jeremy Lickness. I'm a cloud developer advocate, and today I want to show you a fast way to get up and running with CosmosDB. I'm following the Azure CosmosDB Quick Start that's right on docs.microsoft.com. Our first step is to go into the portal and click New, and we're going to select CosmosDB. That's our globally distributed NoSQL database. It's going to spin up and give us a few options to set up what we're going to call this database account or host for what we're going to run and load our data into. Now Azure CosmosDB is prompting me for a unique ID. I'm going to call this my Quickstart DB for the database. It'll ensure that that's unique. And we're going to use the SQL Document DB interface for this. For a resource group, I'll create a new one, call it CosmosDB Quickstart Group. And I'm going to keep the default location of East US. We'll pin this to the dashboard for easy access and click Create. And this will spin up the account that's going to host our various data and collections for us. Now, as you can see, the Cosmos database is set up in the portal, and fortunately, we've got a Quick Start tab that makes it easy to get up and running with data. If you'll notice, I have a button here, Create the Items Collection. I'm going to click that button. What that'll do for me is load a new collection that's ready for me to add data into. So if we go back to the overview and we refresh this, we should see a list of the collection. Here's the to-do list collection. We'll navigate inside of that. And we've got an items collection for data. So I'm going to pick a new document. And for that new document, we'll add some sample data. This comes right off of the Quick Start. If you take a look at the steps in the Quick Start, there's a sample data document item that you can copy and paste right into the portal. So we'll come back here and click Save. And that'll add that data. And then I'm just going to add a second item with an ID of 2. We'll make the description pick up blackberries and it's another good item, watermelon. So I'm going to just change that and click update for that. And now we should have this populated. So the next step that we'll take is in the Quick Start. Notice that we've got the option to download our own .NET app. This is going to give me a zip file that has a fully loaded project ready for me to connect to my CosmosDB. If I come inside this project, what I want to do is first show you this repository class. This is the class that makes the various connections to CosmosDB. You can see with the document API, it's as easy as read document async to pull in a sample document. And then, for example, when we're getting the list of items, it creates a very simple query that's passed to the database and pulls back those items. I want to run this application, but first, I need to set up my secrets. There's two secrets that we provide for this application. These are going to be available in the Keys tab within the portal. The first is the endpoint. We'll copy that endpoint. That's how it accesses the CosmosDB. So I'm going to paste that directly into my web config. And the second is a primary key. And this is a key you want to keep safe. You wouldn't normally share it like I'm doing here. You'd want it configured within your application settings because this is a secret that allows access to the database. Once we've got that in place, we'll click Debug to launch the application. Let that spin up. And what's happening right now is my web browser is opening and setting up client-side debugging through Chrome. It's going to refresh to the localhost endpoint, and you can see that the item that I inserted through the portal is here. I can create a new item. We'll give it a name, new task. This is actually working. And we'll click Create. The list shows that task. We can click it as Edit and make it complete and save, and it drops off the list. So there you have it, the fast, easy way to get started working with CosmosDB right out of the portal.